Yeah, it's a really, really exciting time here in Brussels at Digital Europe for Circo, because we brought all together different parties in the value chain of the electronics sector, and we have four major brand owners here. So Bosch, Siemens, Philips, Technicolor, and Ricoh, together with suppliers of recycled plastics. Those are Coolrec and MBA Polymers, really big ones, and also a big virgin supplier of plastic, the Borealis. And we have also the collectors schemes of Recupel and the Ecosystem. And also technology provider, and we are thinking, or we are working on the subject of how to create large-scale demand for recycled plastics in the electronics sector.
My name is Gisela Lena and I work at Borealis, and I am application marketing manager for the appliance business. I'm really, really happy to be part of this workshop because the subject of sustainability is very important for Borealis, and one of our focus areas is actually on circular economy and really trying to understand the pain that the brand owners have in the subject of circular economy, and how we can help them as a virgin supplier, but a virgin supplier that has invested in a recycler in the last year, how we can support the recycled content in their appliances is part of the workshop discussion, and it's really, really very interesting to see their point of view.
Your company bought a recycler?
Yes.
How big is this part of your business now?
So it's actually, at the moment, a very, very small part of our business.
Mm-hmm.
So the recycler will at least next year have about 30 kilotons
mm-hmm.
of business compared to a Borealis who has 4 million. It's of course a very, very small part at the moment, but it's clearly in our strategy to increase this part because we do believe that the combination of recycled material with virgin material will in future be very, very important, because plastics is just too valuable to throw away. And we want to be part of the second life of plastics.
Smith, I work for Philips in the sustainability department, where I am responsible for working with the consumer product divisions within Philips in trying to implement sustainability throughout all their processes. And I have a specific focus on introducing recycled plastics into our manufacturing lines.
And how is Philips doing related to recycled plastics in the products?
We've had a project in place on recycled plastics since 2010, I would say, and ever since we've been really trying to use more recycled plastics, right? So higher amounts into more products. So at this moment, we have quite a few products on the market, for instance, coffee machines, Senseos, vacuum cleaners, irons, that already use quite some recycled plastics. But we really want to take it to the next level, right? We really want to keep growing the amounts that we put in. So both in those product lines where we really do it, try to innovate into newer materials, but also the product groups where we are not using it yet, to also expand over there. So the ambition is really to keep growing this and to really make it a standard material within Philips.
Okay, and what is the barriers to introduce recycled plastics in your products?
So still, the material properties are not the same as virgin. Right? So they're not necessarily lower quality, but they're different materials, which means that we really need to control the specifications of the recycled plastics and know really well where they are different from the virgin materials, so that we can either adapt our designs, right, or adapt the production processes to match those. So it means it's not a straightforward change. You cannot just pick up a product, buy some recycled plastics and make that change. You really need to test all the materials, right? Really do a production trial, release those plastics. So it's quite a timely process, and you really have to go product by product, right? The plastics that we use in a vacuum cleaner, simply not the same as the plastics that we use in an iron, right? So that means really you have to go product group by product group and slowly introduce it throughout the company.
I'm Sophie Heinz from Korek, organization in specialist in recycling of electronic materials and especially a supplier of raw materials, secondary raw materials, and what we had in also focus on the plastics, so plastic recycling and compounding of plastics coming from the weed.
Okay, and this two-day workshop, what did you learn from these 2 days?
It was very inspirational, especially because the real stakeholders were around the table, and also to have open discussions and also to learn from each other was very, very interesting. To see that we have same views, so that we can go together, but also on the other hand that there are still some different views, but that the focus is the same. This is giving us a boost to go on with the projects we are working on already, so it's confirming that we are doing the right thing. On the other hand, it's really needed to go further in this as well, and not only looking at the recycling sector, but also to what I learned here especially is to go together in this with the virgin plastic sector.